everyone. Today we're going to be talking about my favorite TikToker, Alpha Dom. Now, Alpha Dom has 4,925 followers and 40,000 likes. Now, Jake, why would you be covering such a small creator? And here's the thing. I love this guy's content. I stand by everything he says. He is one of the coolest fellas I've ever seen, and we just have to talk about it. I'm kidding, and that will be obvious once you see these fucking videos. Also, subscribe. I need to get to 275,000 subscribers or something really terrible is going to happen to me, and I can't even express to you what's going to go on. Now, Alpha Dom went super viral recently for posting a video on TikTok called "You Don't Always Have to Accept Her Rejection." And this was posted on Instagram Reels and Twitter all over the place. I, luckily enough, got to find the fella himself and, you know, actually understand what he's saying. A lot of these people are against what he's saying, but it's like he's actually got some good dating advice. Also, don't forget to become a member. Lots of awesome content there. $5 a month. It's cheaper than a Starbucks coffee.
You do not have to accept her rejection.
Right off the bat, you're losing me.
I'm a professional dating coach, and I teach guys how to understand the female mind. Okay. Now, if you're one of the people that haven't applied anything in my course or my videos or anything like that, this video is not for you. This is an advanced technique. This is for the people that have the course, have my videos.
Okay, so this is like a black belt type level move. This is really, really advanced. This is the stuff that's of the gods. The dating gods only know this, like Alpha Dom. And when I think of Alpha, that's who I picture.
Those fucking are applying it, seeing results, and eventually I'm going to put this in the course. I just don't have the time right now, so I'm releasing it now.
And maybe I should
don't have to accept her rejection. Now, here's an example. I was talking to a girl, and she said, oh, you know, I'm not really interested. And I, instead of just going, okay, and then just turning away, I did this. Why would you not be interested in me? I'm the best.
Now, I don't have any experience with going up to someone at a bar or a club, but just knowing what I know, I don't see any way that this would be successful. And here's why. Because when a woman says, no, thank you, and I've learned this from a very young age, that no tends to usually most likely mean no. They're not saying no to sort of lead you on, right? They don't want to fuck you. Sorry. But of course, to this guy, he has a comeback. He says, but I'm the fucking best. I'm the best, so hop in my page.
Wait, I did this. Why would you not be interested in me? I'm the best.
Right.
Absolutely the best. And she's like, oh, how? I'm like, well, you'd have to come over in my house to find out.
Right. You would have to hop into my basement to find out. Come into my van. Promise. I have peeps. I have every flavor. I have every flavor peep. A Dr. Pepper peep is here, I swear. Get in the van. Just get in the fucking van. Sorry, come on. I'm the best. So this kind of reminds me of like when you're in middle school and you're trying to act out how you would ask out a girl. And you're like, okay, so if I say this and she says no, then what I'm going to say is, that's okay. All right, I'm the best. And then if she says yes, then I'll say what kind of date we're getting on. This guy has planned out this whole thing where, first of all, that the girl's even still going to be in front of you, right? He goes, hey, do you want to let me penetrate you? And then they go, no, thank you. He goes, no, but I'm the best. That woman is walking the fuck away. She's gone. All right. You, he goes, but I'm the best. He's talking to literally nobody, but apparently in this fun fantasy, she's still there.
And you'd also have to be okay with kink, and you'd also have to be okay with my mastery of the ropes and the fact I have multiple women. And actually, maybe you wouldn't be the best for me. And now I did turn it around at the end, but I could have left that part out and still got her to start bantering back.
The women that I know, if you were to do that, they would fully vomit on you. If you literally say, yeah, but you don't understand how good I am at mastering at kinks and ropes and tying you up and making you shut the fuck up. And yeah, I'm a little bit of a domination man. And I'm not kidding you. Everybody who I know who has a working brain would vomit on you because of your grossness.
Back and forth. And she did. She started going back and forth with me, and I started building attraction in that because now I had sidestepped her fucking rejection.
Yeah, but what's considered a back and forth? Is a back and forth like her slapping you and you running away?
Action. Granted, keep in mind, I didn't force it. I didn't say, no, you're gonna. I just played into her little fucking game. I knew she was playing with me a little bit or just kind of disengaging. And I
So was she playing with you or was she disengaging, man? Because those are two completely separate things. Playing and bantering is the complete opposite of disengaging. Now, after this video was posted and people were joking about it, Alpha Dom posted a part two on how he structured this viral video. How in the end, this was all just him playing with our minds like he would with most women's minds.
If you watch my video that's going viral right now, that's everybody triggered and upset, welcome. It's been a fun ride. Now, there's a lesson here to be taught. It's unfortunate that so many people fell into it, but...
Is that the Joker? Is that the new cast for the Joker? What are you doing?
So he's like, if you fell into my trap, that's a bad thing? Like, it sucks that there's so many people here. Wouldn't you be excited that you've trapped so many humans like you do in your real life in your basement?
There's a lesson here. If you've ever paid attention to women that have abundance with men, they'll start weeding out men. They'll start giving them shit tests, start like shit testing test. Their behavior. And
you know, when I was super, super sick, I think Boston Children's ordered me a shit test. Is that what you're talking about? Where like you shit into a cup and then you mail it out and then they test that for parasites? That you're talking about a different?
See, which men kind of flip out and overreact, get emotional, and then they weed those out. As a male that has many, many options, I do that as well.
Right.
I'll say certain things to women and just see how they react. Be like, is this girl stable? Is she going to ask questions about it, or is she just going to flip out?
Right.
You saw a very good example of this with that video. That video said something in the first 5 seconds. It's very fucking flashy and aggressive. And most people only focused on that. Most people didn't show the mental capacity to watch that video and the videos after to understand what I was actually talking about.
Oh, but I
watched. But I've had a few girls message me and be like, hey, you know what? You're right. I know girls that do this, or I do this personally.
Nobody said that. I will tell you right now, no girl reached out to you and was like, yeah, I do that too. I actually really enjoy when people start mentioning how sexually great they are when I reject them.
And I've even had guys message me and say, hey, I've seen this before. It's crazy you actually know what the hell's going on with it.
What the fuck are you talking about? Like, I'm actually wondering if this guy's a fucking idiot. I'm going to tell you right now off the bat, I don't have the mental capacity, like you said, I'm just quoting, to finish that fucking video. I'm so sorry. So, I'm going to watch this one on how to sleep with more models. Jesus, that is a bright goddamn shirt.
It's time for this one again. Most guys do it completely wrong. Let me give you...
Man, these captions are ass. Actually shaking.
A secret. It is my reality, and she is just a guest in said reality. One more time. It is my reality, and she is just a guest.
She's just a guest, or a prisoner, or a victim. One of the main reasons I have slept with more models than most men sleep with twos and threes. Start thinking this way. Wait, sorry. With more models than most men sleep with twos and... Is he saying that he's sleeping with twos and threes? I'm lost. One of the main reasons I have slept with more models than most men sleep with twos and threes. Okay. She's just a guest in my life, though. And that's how I enjoy looking at women, you know? Is that this is a man's world. You're just living in it. You're just a guest in my fucking abode. Now, this one's kind of a deep cut. It only has 26 likes, but I think that you're going to appreciate it for what it is, really. This is what makes women... Oh, what's that? The N.
As politically incorrect as this is going to sound...
Okay.
Out of the over 100,000 women that I've had interactions with...
What?
Women strongly react, both emotionally and sexually, to masculine men. The more dominant, assertive... and aggressive I've been, the more wet they get.
How do you know? Now, I don't know much about women. I've only dated one girl my entire life. But how do you know? Do you think that wet is, how do I word this? Like an emotional response? Like something that that's just boom, you know? Done. Is that how your body works? Because that's wild, man. Yeah, this guy was an absolute fucking asshole to me, so oof. Guess you can call me my favorite band, Water Parks.
However, I'm not saying you can club her in the head and fucking bring her back to your cave to do things unconsensually.
Nobody was suggesting that. The idea of a masculine man, when I think of a masculine man, I don't think of clubbing women in the fucking head and bringing them back to your cave so that you can unconsensually have sex with them, man. I think that's you. That's your brain. That's your brain a-twerking. The fuck? What are you talking about? You know what makes women wet? Describing something crazy that you would never do, like clubbing them in the head, dragging their bodies, burning my fingertips. The fuck? Okay, this next one is something that took me a little bit to like fully understand. Like, I would actually like to pull my hair out at this, but it's one of his most viewed videos. It has something like 100,000 views, but only 100 likes, which I think is super telling. Alpha Dom had stitched a video. Okay, we'll start from the beginning. Stitched a video of like this guy choking this girl. It's like, okay, fine. And then he goes, you want to know what's really kinky? And then he shows this.
Two girls in zen ties. It's about as kinky as I can get on TikTok, probably before they take stuff down. but it also keeps them anonymous because I don't want to ruin their lives, you know?
Yeah, I don't want to ruin their lives, you know? You know what would ruin my life? Holy shit, look at these fucking dogs. Look at these webbed toes right here. Dude, your toes are webbed. Nobody fucking you. I mean, also, it keeps them anonymous, but, I mean, can they see out of this? Maybe that's why they're with you. Also, I'd like to see his Chromecast info. Can we find out more info on where you are? Just a bunch of cords down here, always good. A coffee cup behind the TV, so. Solid. And, you know, just the sweetest smile. This makes me uncomfortable.
Some people are mean and don't understand what it's like to be a submissive.
So what did we learn? Stepping out of phenomenon's not a good idea. Anyways,
How are these women tied up in your apartment consensual? Like, now I know that this sounds mean, but I'm dead serious. How? Also, what is this TV over here? I haven't seen a TV like this since a long, long time ago. Do you live with, because you aren't old enough to purchase that brand new. So I'm wondering, how did this end up in your house? And maybe it was in your mom's or grandma's house. Maybe it was in my grandma's house. Holy fuck, this is terrifying. And then somebody comments and says, watch the one in purple. It's clearly a doll. And so this was all part of his other game, because Alpha Dom just plays so many games.
Watch the one in purple. It's clearly a doll. It's amazing. I made that video and picked that portion of it so that someone would say this. And
what do you mean someone would say this? You have five fucking people watching.
You do. You're literally pawns on my chessboard.
You're all pawns on my chessboard. Now, I don't know how to play chess, but you're definitely pawns on my chessboard, and I'm the king. You rook? The fuck? There's no way. Also, this idea that you've been doing this on purpose, bitch, you got five comments and one of them was about that. The fuck? Watch the one in purple. It's clearly a doll. You planned all this out because you thought people were going to say it was a doll?
She's just really good at holding form. But this shows how much the average person has to cope in order to just fathom what my reality and what I'm capable of. But I'll show you. Don't you worry.
Submissive, me too?
Yes, master.
Do you like being my submissive bride?
Yes, sir.
I feel like you just paid these women. Like, absolutely. These are sex workers. That's not fucking possible at all. And you remember how earlier on in this video, he said that he had interacted with 100,000 women. Well, now we can understand what interacted means, right? Were you face to face with them? Did you suck their toes? What happened?
Guys, if you want to believe that the feminist movement, when they say that women and men are the same and they're as good at the same things, if you want to believe that, you're shit with women. Let's be honest. There's no. I've never met a feminist male that can say, oh, I've been with 1,000 women. Oh, I've been matched with over 100,000 women on Tinder.
You've been matched with over 100,000 women on Tinder. Maybe because you're paying the $500 a month fee or whatever the fuck. Man, you are not... That is not you, dude. You're in here huffing WD-40. The fuck? What are you saying, man? This is literally a bag with one of those fucking women in there. Somebody needs to investigate Alpha Dom. And you're probably wondering, how does he match with 100,000 women on fucking Tinder? Oh, maybe because this is what he fucking pretends to look like, dude. He has this weird AI fucking photo. Like, that's not you, man. It's just not. Like, oh god, this is so fucking weird and frustrating. Also, you're a clown. You're saying how you're one of like the fucking best people to learn from and you're charging $10? No way. Proven results with over 100,000 Tinder matches in 2 years, as well as over 1,000 women in his dating lifestyle and multiple women currently with him. You're just a John. You're a John. You go on back pages. What are you talking about? Where do you, if you live in Vegas and are going to bunny ranches, there's a huge difference between fucking 1,000 women and dating 1,000 women. About. Look at that. That's not him. It's not. I'd swipe right on that. That guy's hot as shit. But you used AI to make yourself look fucking more normal. If you were to use a screenshot from any of the fucking TikToks that you filmed, I mean, Christ almighty, man. It's not the same game. It's just not. But like, he claims that this is one of his women, but we've never seen a photo with him and women. All of this just feels fucking wrong, dude. You're selling a course on how to get women. I wish that I could sign up for the course before I post this video, because I know that things are going to be not wiped, but it'll be interesting. does he just teach you how to find women to pay and fuck? Because that there's a huge difference between that and Tinder, man. God, shouts out to the girls who were in his living room with that big fucking box TV. Shouts out to you. I hope he paid you so fucking much. But that's the difference. I think he just has like a wealthy family and is spending it on SWs. I'm being genuine. And he's trying to recoup some of that money by a $10 single time fee. Holy shit. For $5 a month, you could be a member and you get hours and hours of content here. Come on. Ugh. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. Please check out Never Stop, my clothing brand and fund for people with chronic illness. You can also apply for the fund if you need any financial help. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye.